JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for October the 22nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, head of research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against most of the other major currencies on Thursday during the Asian morning Friday. It gained the most versus, AUD, NZD and CAD in that order, while it lost some ground versus the Swiss franc and the Japanese yen. Now, the strengthening of the US dollar and the other safe havens, the yen and the franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie, suggests that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that this was the case only during the European session. Later in the US, the Dow Jones traded virtually unchanged, and both the S&P and Nasdaq gained with the improved appetite rolling somewhat into the Asian session today. We see that Nikkei's 225 was up, Hong Kong's Hang Seng was up, South Korea's KOSPI was virtually unchanged, and only China's Shanghai Composite was down. Now, European stocks pulled back from a six-week high yesterday, perhaps with investors still feeling the heat of Evergrande's decision to abandon plans to sell a $2.6 billion stake in one of its key units. What may have also dented sentiment in Europe may be the fact that although SAP reported better than expected earnings, its CFO said in a separate call with analysts that the group's forecasts for 2022 profits were flat or slightly lower. Having said all that though, market participants appeared willing to buy again during the US session, despite IBM missing its market estimates for quarterly revenue. Perhaps they maintained confidence to the US economy due to data showing that initial jobless claims hit a 19-month low last week, and that existing home sales surged to an 8-month high in September. Now, speaking about economic data, today the spotlight is likely to fall to the preliminary PMIs for October from the Eurozone, the UK and the US. This will be the first sign on how major economies have been performing during this month. In the euro area, both the manufacturing and services indices are expected to have declined somewhat, something that will take the composite index down to 55.4 from 56.4. This could confirm that the latest energy shortages have left their mark on the euro area economy and may weigh somewhat on the euro. However, due to investors already being aware of the matter, a small decline may not come as a surprise, and thus we don't expect a major impact. After all, a composite index above 50 still points to expansion. We believe that a miss of estimates may be needed to trigger some panic selling. For now, we prefer to exploit some further euro weakness against currencies, the central banks of which have already started raising interest rates, or they are expected to do fairly soon. Such currencies are the Kiwi and the British pound. Now, with regards to the UK prints, no forecasts are available, while in the US, expectations are for only fractional changes, which if materialized, we don't expect to have a major impact on the greenback, as they may barely alter expectations around the Fed's course of action. As of now, market participants remain convinced that the committee will begin its tapering process in November, while according to the Fed Fund futures, they expect a 25 basis points hike to be delivered in October 2022. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the Asian session, we already got Japan's national CPIs for September, while during the early European morning, the UK retail sales for the month were out. Both Japan's headline and core rates rebounded within the positive territory, but they still remain well below the Bank of Japan's objective of 2%, and thus policymakers are unlikely to be tempted to start thinking about monetary policy normalization anytime soon. In the UK, both headline and core sales slid by more than expected. Now, with regards to the speakers, we have two on today's agenda, and those are Fed Chair Jerome Powell and San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly. So, that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So, goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.